All right, Shalom, Kohalayim La, Yahab Hashem El Shabbat Hashem Rakakwadash. Double honors to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone who rule well for teaching me this truth. Shalom La Bakaryim. All right, that means peace to the elect. To you brothers out there in the four corners of the world, pushing and teaching this truth with all righteousness and sincerity. To you few sincere sisters as well who bow yourselves to your Israelite husbands. And for those looking for Israelite husbands in Yahab Hashem El Shabbat with all truth and sincerity. Let's say Shalom. Yahweh is the name of the Heavenly Father who the world inwardly calls God. His name means He is. Baha Hashem means in the name. Yahweh Shai is the Son of the Heavenly Father, or the beloved Son of the Heavenly Father, who the world ignorantly calls Christ, whose name means He is salvation, or He delivers. Okay. I'm gonna go into this video real quick. I'm not going to watch the whole thing, you know, minute for minute or whatever. I'm gonna just bounce around to some points, and I'm gonna get some scriptures in the process. You know, I don't have anything like exactly set up or whatever, but I'm gonna just go through the spirit, man, because this video by Poor Man's Podcast, it came out 13 days ago. It says man who was raped at 14 forced to pay child support. Okay, and like I said, this is on Poor Man's Podcast, you know, the Manosphere, guys on YouTube, things of that nature. And you know what I'm saying, like the you know, the Elder Manatazak, you know, GMS Narrators SC07, I believe his page is. Yeah, GMS Narrators SC07. You know what I'm saying? He did a video on these guys talking about how, you know what I'm saying? Like, these ain't the guys, man. You know, all they so-called red pill knowledge, it comes from the scriptures anyway. You know, yeah, they got their life experiences or whatever the case is, but everything that they talk about is literally in the scriptures. But that's not the point of this video. You know, this is going into female excessive liberation in America in today's society. You know, going into the over liberation of the women in this society, man. You know, these sluts and whores, you know, such as America itself, you know, as the scriptures call it, you know, which is spiritually Babylon, Egypt, Sodom and Gomorrah. Okay, there's many scriptures that calls America, which is spiritually Babylon, you know, the whore, man. Okay, the one that said that she will not be a widow and things of that nature. But we're gonna get into all of that through the spirit, man. You know, I'm gonna play this clip real quick.
Are like very brave. yeah, I know that might sound like
you're so brave for loving.
Yeah, you're so brave for being a but no, I'm saying, like, I feel like you give a different perspective of, like, being a right? Because, like, on one side of things, guys, like, these incel guys might be like, oh, like, she's getting ran through.
Is that only you?
All right, so, I want to talk about that word, incel, right quick, right? So she said, and well, first, let me discuss. You can already tell that both of them are complete and pure sluts, and not this one that's on the that's being shown right now, but the one that she's talking to. Both of them are sluts, don't get me wrong. But the one that she's talking to, you know, I had watched the video with her before, and I forgot what page it was. It was No Jumper. It was the No Jumper podcast. She was on the No Jumper podcast. The Asian chick, the other Asian chick that she's talking to, she was on the No Jumper podcast, and she was talking about how she slept with like 50 guys in one night and stuff like that. And so, you know, just by that, like, you see the demeanor of these women, man. You know, you see the demeanor of these women. This is why it's important to not chase women in this society. You know, let me get let's go into some scriptures real quick. All right. Known in her looks. Ecclesiasticus or Sirach chapter 26 verse 9. It says, the whoredom of a woman may be known to her haughty looks and eyelids. And y'all see these women up there. They may look physically attractive on the outside, but inside they're rotting, man. Okay? They're very, very much rotting. Okay? They're dead inside, man, because they're whores. All right. They use their youth, they use their bodily functionality, okay, to attract guys and lure them in. And you know what I'm saying? If a fine ass woman like like them, like if a physically attractive woman like them just bend over, okay, for a guy, what a guy's easily gonna smash, man. You know these guys today, they gonna smash, man. They gonna say yes, okay? And of course they are, you know. Let me jump down. Let me see. Yeah, I'm going to read verse 9 again. It says, the whoredom of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids. Yeah, her proud looks. Okay? And that's what these, that's how these women look. Like, there's no modesty. They don't leave anything to the imagination. All right? They don't cover themselves up. They got skin. They got, they breasts all showing. They might as well be walking around naked, man. Okay? They wear the eyeliner, the mascara. Okay? They got the colored hair. You know, the earrings, the bracelets. Verse 10, it says, if thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly, lest she abuse herself through overmuch liberty. And that's exactly what, you know, the majority of the women in the world do today. Because it's not just America. There's whores. There's sluts and whores all over the place, man. Okay? Even some of them Arab women over there in the Middle East, man. Okay? Even, you know, some of them, they be covered up. But there's still prostitution over there, you know? It says, if thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly. Yeah, like, if you have a daughter, okay, you calling yourself a man of the Lord, you know, your daughter's young enough to still be, you know, disciplined. You know, if her mother isn't damn running shit through her mind, okay, in all manner of wickedness, you're supposed to keep her in straitly, man. Meaning what? You're supposed to get on her case because women are fickle. Okay, women are extremely fickle, you know? They're wishy-washy, man. They flip-flop all the damn time. Their minds are always subject to change, man. They have no grounds, okay? It says, lest she abuse herself through overmuch liberty. That's why you gotta be hard on your daughter, man. Not mercilessly, okay? Not mercilessly, but, you know, you have to show yourself to be a man, you know, through the scriptures. Verse 11, it says, watch over an impudent eye and marvel not if she trespass against thee. Yeah, so if a woman is just disrespecting you, then don't just let it pass. Like, don't just, it'll be all right. You know, it's whatever. She do this all the time. Because, well, you're leaving the door open for her to disrespect you even more, man. Verse 12, she will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler when he hath found a fountain and drink of every water near her. By every hedge will she sit down and open her quiver against every arrow. Okay, again, man, that's the majority of the women in the world. Okay, mainly in America, though. Okay, again, like, look at these broads, man.
They're right. That most
right, but yeah, but it's like, yeah, you're right, but also it's like I'm in control. It's because I actually derive pleasure.
I
from
definitely
it.
Have like learned to have.
Might be like, oh, like she's getting ran through for right. being a. Mm-hmm. But no, I'm saying like. I feel like you give a different perspective of like being a up, right? Because like on one side,
you see it like there's no like there's no shame facing this, man. There's no shame facing this when women like this talk about things of this topic, man. Like talking about sex, talking about being a slut, talking about being a whore. Okay, it's an okay thing now, man. You know, we back in the day, when you called a woman a slut, that was an offense, man. That was a heavy offense. It was like a curse, a so-called curse word, man. Okay, now it's just like if you call a woman a slut today, you know, for whatever reason, if you call a woman a slut today, she's gonna be like, you know, period. You know, like that fucking city girl shit, man. She's gonna say, yeah, period. Yeah, I am a slut, because these women don't care, man. There's no shame faced in this anymore, man. All right, like it was in the ancient world. Hell, they were sluts and whores in the ancient world, man. Okay.
Things guys like these incel guys might be like, oh, like she's getting ran through.
Is that only
used.
Incel guys? They're
right.
Is that most
right? But yeah, but it's like, yeah, you're right. But also, it's like I'm in control. It's because
yeah, and you know these manosphere guys, they talk about as well. And this is the truth today, man. Women control the sexual dynamic. I want to go into that word incel real quick because that's actually a shaming word that women use against men who don't get any play. So, let me go ahead and look into it real quick. Incel. It says, a member of an online community of young men who consider themselves unable to attract women sexually, typically associated with views that are hostile toward women and men who are sexually active. Okay, so and so it means involuntarily celibate. Let me see if I can find that. Yeah, Khan. Josh O'Kane, in recent years, a number of these men have identified as so-called incels, short for involuntary celibates. Okay, so anybody who's involuntarily celibate, it's like I said earlier, basically, like, you can't get no play, or whatever the case is, man. This is actually a shaming word, okay? For anybody who can't get sex. Well, more particularly, any man who can't get sex, man. All right, because let's just be honest, man. Nobody's saying no to a woman in today's society. Okay, no man is gonna say no to a woman in today's society. Okay, except he be wise. Except he have the fear of Yahabah Shem Yashah on him, man. Because we're not trying to get caught up with these sluts and whores. Okay, so they saying just because, you know, anybody who has like these hostile, you know, attitudes toward men and women getting sex easily or whatever, you know what I'm saying, is basically an incel, you know, who is also somebody unable to, you know, get any play, you know. So all of these are just shaming tactics, man. But like I said, these women today, they're not shame-faced, man. Okay, let me get this. Let's see if I can find it. I put shame-faced. 1 Timothy 2 and 9, it says, in like manner also that women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness and sobriety, not with broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. Okay, and this is how our women going out to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, but it's really any woman with the American mindset, man. Okay? Our women, they're supposed to be in modest apparel, man. Okay, not dressing with the booty shorts and, you know, the breasts all out, you know, the stomach showing, okay, the whole face showing, or whatever the case, man. It says with shamefacedness and sobriety. All right, that word sobriety, it means sober. Okay, so she's supposed to be sober-minded, because the scriptures talk about a drunken woman, man. Okay, I believe that was in the same chapter in Sirach the 26. Okay. It says not broided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. Yeah, putting on your little gadgets and things of that nature to show off, to try to attract the man. Okay, in the Israelite household, the father was to marry the daughter off, man. Okay.
Because I actually derive pleasure from it.
I definitely have, like, learned to have, like, really strong boundaries and, like, understand, like,
and this is the hypocrisy of a woman, man, okay? She's learned to have really strong boundaries. There's no, matter of fact, let's just go ahead and get it, man. All wickedness. Hold up. Let me see. Little. Sirach 25 and 19, it says, all wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon her. Okay? All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let this portion of a sinner fall upon her, man. So there is no boundaries when you're being a whore, man. Okay? Because these Americanized women today, when they talk about boundaries and things of that nature, they're just basically talking about saying no to guys that they think are weird, or they basically say yes to any dude that they like, because again, they can control the sexual dynamic. Okay? But even with that, they're still putting themselves in a risky situation, because you never know who the hell you're gonna run into, man. And Yahabah Shem Yashah, who the world calls God in Christ, he's saving these women up until the day of judgment, okay? Until the day of, you know, the martial law, Jacob's trouble, okay? Until the day of judgment. So he could, I'm talking, like, the Lord is going to get busy on these sluts and whores, man. Okay? Because they have no boundaries, man. There is no boundaries, man. So that's her contradicting herself, okay? And she may be a Jake, she may be a heathen, but whatever she is, she's a whore, man. And women like this, they have to be destroyed. They have to be destroyed, man. All right, and they're going to be destroyed in a horrifying way. Okay? Verse 20 says, as the climbing up a sandy way is to the feet of the aged, so is the wife full of words to a quiet man. Stumble not at the beauty of a woman, and desire her not for pleasure. Okay, so, you know, for brothers in this truth, you know, who you know, whether be it you got, you know, a lot of experience with women or you don't, okay, stumble not the beauty out of woman. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't be, you know, just gawking at her, you know, breaking your damn head just to look at the, you know, look at the cheeks, you know, going by or whatever the case is. You got to have some type of control over yourself, man, some type of mental discipline, you know, because at the end of the day, it's just lust, man. And what is lust? A desire for something, what's the word, man? A desire for something, hold up. I forgot the word, Salakia. Basically, a desire for something, you know what I'm saying? Like, unlawful, man. You know, a desire for something unlawful. Let me look at the definition. Lust meaning. It says to have a very strong sexual desire for someone. Very strong sexual desire. And it's not just sex, man, because lust could be for anything, man. You know, but it's mostly associated with lust, man. It says, lust definition meaning in the Merriam-Webster. It says usually intense or unbridled sexual desire, lasciviousness, an intense longing, pleasure, delight, personal inclination. It says to have an intense desire or need, okay? Because that's what, with the way these women in today's society, these sluts and whores, Salakia, the way these sluts and whores dress in today's society, man, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna arouse your lust, man, okay? And as much as we try not to, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you try not to look at a woman, all right? Because you know what the scriptures say. You know, like Yahweh Shah said, like, when you look at a woman, you've already committed adultery in your heart, man. So you already committed adultery. Okay, we in the flesh. We can't help it. If you just crossing the street, you see a woman with a big fat old ass just walking right in front of you, man, with short shorts on. Okay? She got the cheeks all out or whatever the case. You can't help that. Okay? But it says, stumble not at the beauty of a woman and desire her not for pleasure. Meaning what? Control yourself, man. Don't just want a woman because you want to have sex, okay? I'm going to jump down to verse 25 because that's heavy. It says, give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to gad abroad. If she go not as thou wouldest have her, cut her off from thy flesh and give her a bill of divorce and let her go. Okay, well, in this society, man, there is no, like, really marrying a woman who's already been touched, man. Okay, because the word sex means to cut. All right, so when you pop the cherry, so to speak, okay, that's marriage, man. That's real sex. All right, when you have sex with a woman, okay, when you take her virtues, so to speak, man. Okay. But it says, verse 25, give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to gad abroad. And that's all these sluts and whores in today's society do, man. They gad abroad. Okay? See, that was Satan, man. It took me off of the damn video. You know? But it's all through the spirit. Let me see. Go back to the library.
Please, Caesar. Caesar. Wait, why did I get Marlin?
His name is Nick
Oli. You know, Satan got to do his little work, man. Okay? So that was the point on that clip.
We live in a cap.
And you know, the reason why all of this is happening is because it was prophesied. It was already foretold that women in the latter days, you know what I'm saying, is just going to wax worse and worse, man. It was told in a foretime that it was going to be like this, man. Okay? While women control everything in a society. But let me get through these next couple clips and I'm going to get the scriptures.
Society, and between 2018 and 2019, I was reading a lot of articles about teen pregnancy being the lowest it's ever been in American history. Women are choosing not to have kids, and then we also have the mortality issue. And so for the
they're choosing not to have kids, all right, but they're still choosing to have sex. Okay, Because in this society, man, you got the birth control, man. Okay, and I believe her name was Margaret. Let me go look up her name, man. Hey, you whores or something else. Hey, the Lord is, I'm telling you, like, the Lord is really gonna get with you whores, man. All right? The Lord is really gonna get with you sluts and whores, man. All right? And a brother did a video, you know, Lil Will and I found it and stuff like that, but I only saw the title of the video, but it, you know, the brother was talking about how brothers get with women, okay, to get judged, for the woman to get judged, something along them lines, man. So like, I forgot the name of the video, but it was basically talking about, you know what I'm saying, these women may get with a brother to get marked or to get judged and stuff like that, man. All right, so whether you come into the truth with a rib, okay, or you had a rib before the truth, or you get a rib after the truth, man, you know, whatever the case is, you may get that woman, you know what I'm saying, for the Lord to judge her, man. You know, you may be dwelling with her, you know what I'm saying, trying to do your manly duties as an Israelite man, you know what I'm saying, like, you know, provide, protect, whatever the case is, you know, please your woman or whatever, and stuff like that, and the Lord may, you know, have it to the point where he cut her off from your flesh, you know, she might turn out to be an all-out damn demon, you know, and that's okay, because that was the Lord judging her, that was the Lord getting payback for you, okay. But this is Margaret Sanger, all right? It says, Margaret Higgins Sanger, also known as Margaret Sanger Slee, was an American birth control activist, sex educator, writer, and nurse, okay? She was the one who was pushing for birth control to get, like, normalized and legalized in the modern world, man, okay? This damn devil right here. All right, she's a part of the reason. All right, she's the main part of the reason why these women today, like, they have the birth control pills, you know, that condoms exist, you know, the damn shot. I forgot what it was called, but it's a shot that you could get that'll prevent you from having kids and things of that nature, man. Okay, the Plan Bs, you know. She was the main part of it, man. Okay? And let's go to this article right here in USA Today. It says, remove statues of Margaret Sanger, Planned Parenthood founder tied to eugenics and racism. It says, all across America, video of activists attacking statues plays on a loop while some political leaders voice their support for removing all reminders of people whose personal histories put them in a negative light. Now, if that's the case, then it should be all of these damn Edomites, man, these so-called white people. All of these statues and things of that nature need to be removed, because the history of America, okay, was based off of the blood, sweat, and tears, okay, the violence, the atrocities of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. The atrocities of you so-called white people because of what y'all did to us, okay? It says, in asking for the U.S. Capitol to be cleansed of Confederate statues, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi said they must go because of their efforts were to achieve such a plainly racist end. New York Governor Andrew Cuomo said on NBC's Today Show that removing statues is a healthy expression of priorities and values. Okay, these damn Edomites don't care about priorities and values, man. Because the priority is keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, but they don't care about that. All right, their judgment is perverted. It's corrupt. All right, because that's what the word pervert means. All right, it means to corrupt. Okay, so if priorities and values were such in essence to these damn white people, these so-called white people, okay, then the law, statutes, and the commandments of the Heavenly Father would still be in effect. All right, but they're not. Okay. It says, for those identifying historical figures with racist roots who should be removed from public view because of their evil histories, Planned Parenthood's founder, Margaret Sanger, must join that list in promoting birth control. She advanced a controversial Negro project, wrote in her autobiography about speaking to a Ku Klux Klan group, and advocated for a eugenics approach to breeding for the gradual suppression, elimination, and eventual extinction of defective stocks Those human weeds which threaten the blooming of the finest flowers of American civilization. So here it is, man. Here it is, you so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American women. Y'all want to be sluts and whores so bad? All right? Here's what your enemy has to say, is trying to do to you, man. To this day. Okay? To this very day. This chick, her family, all right? They still making money off of this whole Planned Parenthood thing, man. Your enemy wants to destroy you, but y'all still want to be out here sluts and whores. Okay? And that's okay because the scriptures say this. Let me get this in the book of Amos 7. Hold up. It was Salakia. It's Micah 7 and 9. I always get these two mixed up for some reason. Micah 7 and 9. Or rather 10. It says, "Then she that is mine enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which said to me, where is the Lord thy power? Mine eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets." Yeah, going into you women, man. All right? For all you women that got with brothers to get marked are for death. All right? For the ones playing with brothers' sexual urges. You know, rejecting brothers' kindness and gentleness and things of that nature. All right, literally talking about where's the Lord thy power? Yeah, where's your God? God ain't gonna do shit. I'm a proud this. I'm a bad be that, and all of this other shit. Hey, the Lord gonna get with y'all, man. Okay, and be afraid, man. Be very afraid. All right, because the Lord is not a power that he should be mocked. You know, and that's all y'all do. Because what? Let me get this as well. First Timothy 5 and 6, it says, "But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth." Okay? And this scripture is twofold because it talks about America too, man. The scriptures talk about America, which is Babylon, okay? Or the daughter of Babylon, the daughter of the Chaldees, okay? Is living deliciously right now, man. Okay? Opening his legs to all of these different nations, but you know, exports and imports. And things of that nature, man. The elite, the Illuminati of this society, they got all the riches, they got all the gold, they eat all the best food, okay? They got all the best resources, okay? But everybody outside of them is suffering, man, okay? But when Yahabah Shem HaShah come back, all of that shit is going to get put to a naught, man, all right? And then the other part of this scripture is, you know, literally going into you women, man. All right, because what? Y'all living in pleasure. All right? Again, y'all are controlling the sexual standard, the sexual dynamic. Okay? Y'all able to have sex with whoever the hell y'all want to, man. Y'all able to say whatever the hell you want to everybody with no consequences, man. All right? Y'all don't have to hold yourselves accountable. You know? That's why this society is a damn joke, man. All right, this is why we need righteousness. This is why we need justice back in its full effect. This is why we need Yahabah Shem Yahawashai. All right? That shit ain't cool when you meet a woman and then, you know what I'm saying, you gotta bear the thought that somebody else already popped her. You know what I'm saying? She done got ran through before, whatever, you know, to brothers who seek to get, you know, a woman or whatever the case is, man. All right, but the scriptures say, that wife should be a harlot in the city, man. All right?
For the first time in American history, the main concern is who's going to replace the workforce if women are choosing not to have kids. And I'll show you right here. As you can see here, it's always been about the economy. That's why you see the Texas abortion ban and being a topic of conversation now. It's not about pro-life or family and love. It's
and they decreeing all of these decrees and things of that nature, but not, I can't even say they're not considering, man. All of this shit is being done for you know, all spiritual reasons or whatever. But you know, first of all, this whole abortion ban is, it's not gonna work, man, because with the fucking the level of wickedness with these women, they're gonna find a way to abort a child anyway, man. All right, I think it's the new Texas law that she's going into is talking about how I think it's after 15 weeks. If a woman has been pregnant for 15 weeks, she could not get an abortion. Matter of fact, let me see if I can pull it up, man. Because I was looking at that the other day through the spirit. Texas abortion. Let me see if I could pull it up. Slack, Yakim, just bear with me. As of September 1st, 2021, the state of Texas has enacted a new abortion restriction known as Senate Bill 8. This law limits our ability to provide abortion care in Texas beyond about 6 weeks of pregnancy and sometimes even earlier. We are fighting this law in court and we are still here for you. I don't think this is the one I was looking at. Nah, this ain't the one I was looking at. Let me see if I can find it, man. Through the spirit. Texas abortion law after 6 months. It says, let me see where I can start at. It says the law bans most abortions as soon as any cardiac activity can be detected, usually around 6 weeks of pregnancy or about 2 weeks after a missed period. Most women don't know they're pregnant at that point. Yeah, Khan, so, all right, so it is 6 weeks. So, like, I thought I was reading something else about abortion. But in any wise, man, you know, first of all, they ain't gonna be no more. There ain't gonna be no fucking abortion in the ancient world, man. There ain't gonna be no, you know, abortion in the kingdom of heaven. You know, rather, I'll say it like that. There ain't gonna be no abortion in the kingdom of heaven, man. Okay, because you taking life, man. You know, there ain't gonna be no abortions among our women or among the heathen women in the kingdom of heaven, man. All right, to you so-called Negro, Latino, Native American women, y'all gonna be in order. You ain't gonna have a choice, realistically. All right, you ain't gonna have no choice, you know?
Let's get back to it. It's about having the society run on workers and keeping our choice away from us.
Well, this is also the first time in human history women actually have the choice. People have to understand, historically speaking, women were using their fertile years getting pregnant. Women weren't in the workforce because men oppressed them.
As they should. Okay? And again, as they should, man. All right? And that's exactly how it's going to be in the ancient world, man. We're going to get our women young, man. Okay? We're going to get, as soon as they hit the flower of their age, man, as the scriptures say, that's when we're going to be able to, you know, deal with our women, man. And they're going to be our women, you know?
Women weren't in the workforce because they had to have children because there wasn't any social security until about 1935 or sometime in there. With a slice of bread costing $500 next year.
His name is Nick Olivas, and when he was 14, he had a sexual relationship with a 20-year-old. Now, it's important to keep in mind that according to Arizona state law, children younger than the age of 15 are not...
Now, what this clip right here is going into is a dude who was 14 years old. When I seen a picture of him, he looked like a Jake. He looked like he might have been a Jake, man. But he was 14 years old, and this 20-year-old woman had came on to him, or whatever the case was, and in the state of Arizona, anybody under the age of 15 is considered statutory rape and things of that nature. So, like, I'm gonna just play the clip, and this shit was crazy, man.
Able to consent as an adult under any circumstance. So, as you know, this was a case of statutory rape, and the law did go after the 20-year-old woman who had a sexual affair with him. Now, regardless of the fact that he was a victim, it turns out that the state is now going after him for child support. Apparently, the woman who had sex with him when he was 14 got pregnant, and he didn't know about it until 6 years later. And then they contacted him and said, hey, you know what? You actually owe $15,000 in back child support.
There is a good reason.
That's all I'm playing on that video, man. Let me get this. Jeremiah 31:22, it says, how long wilt thou go about, O thou backsliding daughter? For the Lord hath created a new thing in the earth, a woman shall compass a man. Okay? That's why the women in this society is able to basically do whatever the hell they want to do, man, with little to no consequence. This is why they could be celestial whores. This is why they could get abortions, or, you know, do the whole Planned Parenthood thing, okay, without consequence, okay? Let me get this in the book of Hosea. I believe it was, yeah, it was Hosea, chapter 4. Let me see. Hosea 4:14, it says, I will not punish your daughters when they commit whoredom, nor your spouses when they commit adultery. For themselves are separated with whores, and they sacrifice with harlots. Therefore the people that doth not understand shall fall. Okay, so, and this is further going into why our people are the way they are today, man, because of, by reason of idolatry. So because Israel, Yusoko, Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans have played the harlot with these other nations, okay, the so-called white man, the Chinese, Japanese, Arabs, Africans, okay? So because we played the harlot, we played the whore with every other nation under the sun, okay? And we didn't want to be that woman until Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, the comely and delicate woman under Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. The Lord said, what? I will not punish your daughters when they commit whoredom. So this is, again, this is why we have these sluts and whores all over the place, man. And it's right, it's just judgment, man. Okay? Is the Lord not fair in judgment? Is the Lord not righteous? Is the Lord not equal? Okay? The Lord said, I will not punish your daughters when they commit whoredom, nor your spouses when they commit adultery. All right? So a man or a woman, man. Okay? This is why you get the good guy who gets fucked over by the bad girl. This is why you got the good girl that gets fucked over by the bad boy and things of that nature. There are no bounds, man. There are no bounds. Except Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai have mercy on you. Okay? So if you're not, not even brothers in the truth is safe from these whores out here, man. We're not even safe from these whores, man. Okay? Because even if you do meet a woman in the truth, that don't mean she's going to be your rib. That don't mean she's going to be your wife. This don't mean that she's going to be with you till Yahweh Shai come back and deliver y'all. Hell fucking no, man. So not even we safe, man. The prophets before us, they wasn't safe. Okay? But it's all through the Spirit. All right? It says, for themselves are separated with whores, and they sacrifice with harlots. Therefore, the people that doth not understand shall fall. Though thou, Israel, play the harlot, yet let not Judah offend, and come not ye unto Gilgal, neither go ye up to Bethaven, nor swear the Lord liveth. Well, yeah, that was the point. You know what I'm saying? You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans have played the harlot, man. Okay? That's why our women are whores and harlots and things of that nature, man. All right? But the scriptures say what? You know, she that liveth in pleasure, you know, is dead while she liveth, man. All right? So, hey, so you women on the side, man, you sluts and whores on the side, man, y'all could go ahead, y'all could live it up, man. Y'all could go ahead with all your shaming tactics, you know, talk about, you know, brothers' penis sizes and bedroom business, okay, and height, all right, and spiritual matters and things. Y'all could go ahead, y'all could do all your shaming tactics. You could do whatever the hell you want, because at the end of the day, the Lord going to destroy you, man, you know? Oh, matter of fact, I'm going to close out with this scripture. I'm going to close out with this scripture, Isaiah 4:1. It says, and in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will not eat our own, Salakia, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. Yeah, and, you know, during the time of Jacob's trouble, you know, women, there are going to be women who's going to come up to the camps, you know what I'm saying, to many different camps, many different brothers, trying to get saved, man, inquire about salvation, okay? So in that day, seven women, it may be seven women, maybe four, it may be 10, 20, okay? It says she'll take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Yeah, we're going to get our own food. We're gonna wear our own clothes. It says, only let us be called by thy name. All right, because you know when you get a wife, so to speak, when you get a wife, she's called under your name. She's under your name, she's under your household. Now, how does she come under your household? All right, you gotta have sex with her, you gotta sleep with her. All right, that's how a woman is called by your name. Okay. It says, only let us be called by thy name, because, you know, they're going to try to be all humble. All right. They're going to try to come back and apologize. All right. And now this hasn't happened yet, but it's getting closer and it's getting closer, man, because these and, you know, the poor man's podcast, dude, you know, he was talking about how he was talking about the economical collapse, man. All right. Which is going to happen, you know, soon to come. All right. It says, only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. So y'all going to want to get, you know what I'm saying, forgiven of your transgressions and your sins and all your mockery and foolery against the men of the Lord. All right. That's how bad these times are going to get, man. When the proudest of the proud women humble the fuck down and they start begging brothers for salvation and things of that nature, man, that's how bad it's going to get, man. Okay. Now, that don't mean brothers is going to deal with you, okay? That don't mean brothers is going to say, oh, yeah, I got you, because we're going to be worrying about trying to save ourselves, okay? But, hey, it's all through the Spirit, man, you know? Hey, the scriptures say, I will make a man more precious than fine gold, all right? So there's nothing special about you, harlots, man. You know, I'm sorry you think so, but at the same time, it's like, look, the Lord gonna get with you, man. For all of your wickedness, for all of your wicked ways, for all malice, all right, against the men of Yahabashim Yahawashai. All right. So with that being said, I'm gonna say, call Allah Yahabashim Yahawashai. Shalom.